All right, everyone, today is pretty exciting because we're going to be reviewing the project management tool, Kanbanize. Wait, hold on. It's not Kanbanize, it's Kanbanize. Wow, I read that completely wrong. I accidentally switched the letters I and Z. That's embarrassing. I can feel my second grade teacher's disappointment with my reading skills from here. Look, in my defense, Mrs. Durnett, it's not a real word. But it is a real PM service. Hello, project managers. I'm Mackenzie, and today I'm reviewing the PM software Kanbanize. Before we jump into the review, let's do a little history roundup. Kanbanize was founded back in 2008, and it is the product of Business Map, a private software company with headquarters in Bulgaria and offices in Spain and Brazil. Its founders are proponents of lean thinking and continuous improvement, as well as Kanban practitioners. They believe that Kanbanize can help companies manage big initiatives deployed across multiple teams. The company's mission is to help people do meaningful work, which then helps create more room for innovation. But does Kanbanize actually live up to the company's mission? Let's go through all of its top features to find out. Let's start with the obvious, Kanban boards. Kanbanize provides users with Kanban boards where they can map workflows and keep track of tasks, relieve bottlenecks, and get accurate status reports. The visual tool shows full transparency of work with work items visualized as cards. Users can create a network of interlinked boards and connect multiple workflows across the organization. Its Kanban boards enable the management of dependencies across teams and departments. This is done easily thanks to the swim lanes that split the boards into sections and the ability to merge cells across those lanes and columns. There's also subcolumns, card templates, and custom board backgrounds. Along with all of that, Kanbanize cards have several properties and functions to help users customize work items as needed, including custom fields, subtasks, custom work item types, configurable task settings, and dependency management. Teams can use mentions, attach files, send notifications, and use visual tokens to identify blockers or add labels. Up next is work management features. Users can customize boards to meet the specific needs of teams. A multi-layer board allows for multiple workflows for better organization and process improvement. It includes an initiative workflow on top of the swim lane, ideal for bigger projects. The timeline workflow lets users visualize past, current, and future projects in a calendar view. Other features are policies, service level expectations, and WIP limits. Then there's flexible workspaces, which allow teams to distribute and track work across the organization with increased visibility in projects, as well as connected planning and execution. The workspaces are ideal for distributing and tracking work across multiple teams from a single board. Team workspaces let users bring together different boards to boost collaboration in a department. And user roles allow admins to create and assign roles with corresponding board and task permissions. Fun fact, Kanbanize includes dashboards with customizable layouts. Users can create widget-only dashboards as informational hubs to provide summarized reports. The advanced search tool includes filters so users can search data by particular category. The Agile project management tool also has project forecasting functionality that uses specific criteria to derive automatic forecasts. The built-in Monte Carlo simulation feature helps teams determine how many work items they can complete for a given period of time. On the side of workflow, analytic tools include visualizations such as cumulative flow diagrams, cycle time scatter plots, cycle time heat maps, cycle time histograms, throughput run charts, aging WIP, and flow efficiency, among others. All these help teams analyze performance and optimize process efficiency. Kanbanize gives users if this, then that automation rules to facilitate everyday work. It has a drag and drop rule builder that lets users create conditions that trigger predefined actions, such as after creating a card, after updating said card, or after the status of a child card changes. Users can introduce different work-in-progress limits to reduce the multitasking and keep a steady flow of work. Teams can set WIP limits per user, per column, per lane, per cell, or add limits per group or columns. Kanbanize integrates with many apps and services, such as Power BI, Data Studio, Tableau, Azure, and many more. It also integrates with cloud storage services, development tools, and middleware solutions with native mobile apps for iOS and Android. Overall, I think Kanbanize has a lot of useful features that can allow teams and organizations to create high-level overviews of their projects and portfolios. But the UX is a lot different from what I'm used to, at least. So I highly recommend requesting a demo or trying out its 14-day free trial before committing to a payment plan. The link is in the description. Or if you want a more in-depth review of Kanbanize, then go read this article. And go ahead and ask your fellow project managers about it in the comments below. But while you're here, be sure to click the like icon, hit the subscribe button, and read more at project-management.com for other PM tools. Thanks for watching.